Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. We're in our harvester here in Goldcrest Valley, and I'm going to move it to a new home. So I think I want to put the one of the new cultivators back over there where this guy was. So let's get this guy put down over here, at least for now, till we figure some things out. All of the conveyor belts can leave this area when we do pick up fields, I think 3 and 4. That'll kind of empty this area out. And the beet harvester over where this guy was can move over there too. So eventually we'll be shuffling equipment over to different parts of the map. For now, let's park this guy in here so that I can do a couple things this episode that look like they'd be kind of fun. But first of all, I'm going to put this guy away, and this guy is dirty. This warrior has been busy playing in the mud. All right, let's go give him a bath and put him away. I need to use this guy. You can imagine that trailer right there, full of seed and fertilizer, park it under a garage roof somewhere, and be able to just truck it out to wherever we need for a major planting day or something like that. Or run over here where it's quieter. There we go. Let's clean all this stuff up and put it away, because I want to go do some spraying over in our field 13 and the new grass triangle next to it. That's cleaned up pretty good. Let's get this guy done. And while we're at it, we may as well pick up field 9 next to it. It needs to be fertilized as well, and it's already planted and ready to go. So it seems like a good plan, good use of the money or the time. There we go. After that, if there's time, there's something else I want to dive into that looks like fun. I'm going to spend the next few episodes continuing to play with the Kuhn equipment pack. Just because it's kind of new and fun, you know, lots of people are looking for it right now. And you know, a lot of people are looking to see if it's something that they want to invest in. So they want to see actual gameplay. So that sounds like a worthwhile use of our time here. Let's do that and drive out to the shop. So I will meet you there so we don't spend too much time on the road this episode. Well, there's our lone tipper over there, just waiting for a home. Gotta get him home soon. But for now, I'll tell you what, let's put him in the parking lot. Maybe he'll be less likely to be stolen in the night. Where to? Good pull-through spot. I'm thinking right over here. Yeah, looks pretty good. Alright, he won't be so lonely there, so we'll park next to him. Keep him company. But we want to get some spraying done, and we do already own a sprayer. Now, of course, there are other ways to do it, too. We can spread manure, which we will be doing soon as the cattle get a chance to get ahead. We could fertilize with a spreader and dry granular fertilizing. We can take the slurry that's been being made over at, I think, both. You know, I haven't this in Farming Simulator 17 verified it, but back in 13, used to be able to get slurry over at the biogas plant from the silage that you would process. So I'm assuming that you can get that there too this time. But either way, we don't have enough to make these work, and we'll have to buy a whole bunch for this. But I want to get back into this again because we've got some of the more implements of the Kuhn equipment pack available. Now, we've already got... will this guy scroll? Yeah. We've got this guy already, which is 15 meters wide and holds 1,200 liters. We could add this guy to it for another 1,000 and get 2,200 out of this. Or we can go this route here. We're at 21 wide, so what is that, 63 feet, and 13 and 15, so another 28, am I getting that right? Yeah, 2,800 liters. This guy right here, see, I took my handy-tandy Stanley 12-foot measuring tape out and walked over to Field 9, that other one owned by Joshua Allen, where it's got the sunflower sowed in it right now. And what I discovered, this 36 meters wide spans that field perfectly. It was made to go there. And it does a great job of wiping this little bit larger field out, which is quite a bit larger, probably twice as big as any of these. Well, twice as big as this guy at least, and looks like, you know, 2.5 times this and 1.5 times that. He's a big one. There's our grass right there. I don't know what these little nubs are right here. It's a little bit different colored green. Not sure. It's claiming to be... Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, I digress. Anyway, that one will work great in 9 and 13, and as well as some of these other ones, whatever we end up getting into later. So I'm going to do that. Let's see, back into here. Afterward, I'm thinking of getting into windrowers right there. We've got this guy. I eventually want this guy. He does almost 15 meters. This one is really exciting. He's really expensive for being the same width as what we've already got, so I can't justify buying it. 9.3 meters and 9.1 meters. It does the same job, and he's 5 times the cost. So this is something I think I'm going to lease for a one-time use just to show how it works. That one, I played with it a little bit offline, and it's kind of like this. It kicks it all off to one side and knocks it into a row on the side, but it's quite fun to watch it do its job. Enough to where it's worth leasing it one time and getting the chance to see it. You know what I haven't really done? Let's do a quick review of all of the new implements of that pack. I'm just going to very specific ones, but let's see if I can track these down. Plows? Nope, nothing new in plows. Okay. That's one that's already been here. So, headers, cultivators, we've seen all of these, though eventually I'd like to get into these guys as well. This one right here, yeah, same description. This one will, let's see here, that will sow grass and oilseed radish as well. Is there a capacity? 400. Very little. Interesting. You'd think it'd be very different. This is a pretty good sized cultivator. Something you'd use in a much larger field. You'd think it'd have at least 1,000 available to it to be able to oilseed radish the entire thing. Anyway, that guy looks real interesting when it drops. The blades come down at a bit of an angle. And looks quite exciting to watch. Another good sized one over here. Kind of a middle range between this and the others. We've bought these two already. And that's all we've got in the Kuhn equipment pack. This one was already with us. In fact, we started with that one, I believe, right? Is he in our garage? Yeah. Then we get into the sowers. And have we seen everything here? There we go. So we picked up this guy. We just cleaned him up and put him in the garage. These two were part of the plow cultivator setup. And this guy sows the other crops, the sunflower, soy, corn, and beets. And that is it there. What I don't know, these are the weights, so he doesn't connect to any of these. I'm curious, though, if something I wanted to experiment with at some point. We'll go back to cultivators. This guy over here, three-point hitch goes into it, three-point hitch comes out of it. Why can't he go in between almost anything with a three-point hitch? That makes sense. He seems like he can be an adapter between the tractor and anything that is similar to this guy. So it seems like he should be able to connect right into, one of these. Why can't we put the plow? Well, we can't do it here because it's not a three-point hitch. It has a trailer. But that's a 3-point hitch. That's, well, that is, yeah, but this is a 3-point hitch. You think you'd be able to plow? I guess you need to cultivate in between. Okay. So could this guy mount in place of this one? He's got his own seed right there. We'll play with that a little bit someday. That's just a question I've got. I wonder, curious, because if we click on this, we only get the weights, the AGO and the, what was the SB? SB stood for what? Sawyer? Yeah, Sawyer. Or sewer? Well, I'm thinking Sawyer, but it's probably sewer or yeah, something like that. So, other categories, that was one too many backs. So, we've also got in the Kuhn pack, auger wagon. What is officially an auger wagon? Auger wagons are trailers that have their own screwer conveyor. You can use them to store your crop, directly unload it into other trailers. Okay, so for transferring goods from one to another. Okay, but the sprayers we've seen, eventually I'd love to get into this guy, but you know, $500,000, I just can't justify that. Can't do it, sorry. So our weeder, there weren't any new weeders. Slurry tank? No. Manure spreader? No. Fertilizer spreader? I think there was. Yes, Kuhn pack, you are a fertilizer spreader of 3,200 liters. That's a pretty good size one. So that mounts either to the front or the back of a tractor that's got 3-point hitches on both and PTOs. And it just sprays out a huge arc in front of the tractor. A little bit harder, in my opinion, to use as far as being able to predict where it's going to spray and hit. You got to turn it on long before you get into the field, as you're approaching the field, and as you've got to run almost off the field, which seems like there's a lot of waste beyond the field by the time you finally get the back of the arc to hit the sides of your pathway. So I've kind of stayed away from these. I like the sprayer because you see exactly where it's going to land and you can stop it right at the edges. So it's nothing unpredictable. The slurry, see if we can get into those, is the same way. Slurry spreaders, they just send this big old tail of slurry splashing out the back end. So you've got to figure out where to start and stop. Don't see any Kuhn pack in there. Manure, fertilizer, weeder, mower. There is a little mower with that DLC. Right there, he's kind of like this guy over here. So $9,000 buys the Pottinger, 3 meters wide, 80 horsepower. This guy, one more, is 4.3 meters. What did I say that one was? 3 meters, so you know, half time bigger. And 80 horsepower, so it'll run on any tractor. And kicks it all off to one end, I'm guessing. I'm not sure. But it looks very similar to these, the Lilies. But 3-point hitches there. Sticks straight out, probably for transport. I would imagine he swings off to one side when he's running. That's my guess. Anything else? Where are my mowers, tedders? The windrower there is. That's this guy. And that's it? Yeah. So this guy kicks everything off to one end against the screen right here. So is that it? Kind of going through my memory here. Baling, there is more. And I'm thinking next episode, and well, maybe the one after that. I'm taking a lot longer doing this little perusal of the equipment than I was planning. This guy right here is a square and round bale wrapper. Got two, this whole thing accordions out, and you got two wheels here and two wheels here, picks up both of them and just kind of flips them all back and forth inside this cage while all the foil wraps around. It's real exciting to watch. This one over here is a round baler with the bale wrapper built into it. So it's basically this and this put together to give you a round bale that kicks out into a little cradle behind it, wraps it, and then dumps it off. So both stages are done together. I'm curious if the auto unloader does anything to this as well. I don't know if it's triggered specifically to run on this guy or if it'll do anything that makes round bales. So that I don't know. This is a big square baler. That's what I would like to get eventually. So we can get this guy right here, which loads 16 bales at once, big squares or rectangular bales, and makes a huge stack when it unloads it. But this would be fun to watch. I don't know if I want to make that investment, but this would definitely be worth leasing for $10,000, which I'm sure we could easily recoup the $10,000 in the silage bales that we're going to make from it. So that's something coming up soon. I think I want to do that one, even if just a lease. Anyway, what am I here for? I am here for the sprayer. So let's actually make that happen before I get too distracted here. Sprayers. Let's go for this guy right here. And I'm thinking that's a permanent purchase, not a lease. I think we're going to use that in all of the big fields from here on out. So select, no choices, and $6,000 to lease or $84,000 to buy. I think we're going to get our money's worth out of that. So let's buy that one. Yes, 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 thank you, okay, and back, and not back. He, come back here, holds 4,100. You guys are 2,000. Let's get two of these guys. Buy, yes, okay, buy, yes, okay. All right, that's this episode's plan, as well, maybe the windrower, if there's time. If not, the windrower will be next episode. Jump in our warrior here and bring this guy home. There we are. Yeah, just fill it up right there. So this guy, let's take a look at him. Looks like a steering linkage right there. Nope, it's not going to let me make contact. Be curious to see if these wheels, they steer. Look at that! I like it when you see all the different animations. Yeah, that is a steering linkage. Alright, fill you up. What else is in here? So if I steer the tractor, no, only when it's driving. Good. That's good to see. Wouldn't want these guys just to grind into the ground like I'm doing to the front tires up there. I would expect it to happen as it moves. Wonder how that works. Wonder what tells it what direction you're going. Something that just leans over I'm always asking how and why and how come and how does it work. And anyway, let's go and turn it that way. Might just be more of a gravity thing or a weight shifting over. Cantilever. Okay, let's dive off to field 13. I don't think I'm missing anything. It's kind of like taking the sower out to the field and getting there and realizing you didn't put seed in it. What am I not thinking of? I think I've got it all. Am I tracking pretty straight? I think so. Call that straight there. Take a look at this guy. Oh, I can get underground. Kenny didn't see that. Yeah, he's exciting. Oh, forgot. Get the cute little beacon going there. This is the Mad Max of the tractor series. The Road Warrior. Alright. Tell you what, I'll meet you over there. Alright, just around this bend here. Our little turn off, except I'm going to go past. Now, did a lot of contracting work for Joshua Allen with the goal of getting these two fields. I was actually looking for field 9 first, back when we were trying to do everything out of our own pocket before great-great-grandfather Nash Rambler left us all the funds. But this field over here, jump out of here. I think we want to get it. It's planted in sunflower seeds right now, and it's going to make a good addition to us. We'll be able to work with both of them at the same time over here. Kind of a couplet for us. So let's jump in here and talk to Mr. Allen one more time. who says, let's get straight down to business. You want to work? I've got a field that needs fertilizing. Job pays $4,000. You in? Well, $88,000, I think that's a great deal for 1.37 hectares. Let's go for it. I'm going to buy this one from him. And what's really exciting about this is I can fertilize it in one pass with this guy. So let's do it. And let's do it before this thing unfolds, or we're going to hit trees. This thing is huge. All right, I got to zoom all the way out just to appreciate the size of it. And that's actually enough to do it. Now, this would be nothing to do on my own, but I'm still going to go ahead and hire it out. Just because the AI is nice and straight, and I get to ignore, you know, not pay attention and just enjoy watching the experience. Though if I was doing it alone, I'd probably lower that thing down a little further. He's kind of looking funny up there in the air. I would think it'd be normally down lower anyway. In fact, I'm curious. If I were to unhire you and hit the brakes, and what is it? Mouse and down. Will the AI leave it down there? Higher. He will. So that's up to me to set it correctly. Okay. Good to know. But, Tim, I'm going to do what I didn't do the last couple of episodes and didn't realize it till I was editing and the whole time thinking, boy, I wish that little map wasn't in my way. So, let's get rid of that. But when the AI runs it, it's going to cost us a few dollars. Not that much to pay his wages. But I know it's, you know, you're getting more and more off this edge over here. Nah, I think we're fine. But I can head in here and kind of look things over. Kuhn, Metris, 4102. Now this is a, looks like a kind of a polyurethane plastic tank. Too bad you can't see fertilizer sloshing back and forth inside. Kind of just barely visible. That'd be just the finishing touches to realism, but I like the all the hoses running out here, the little blue spray heads. Looks like something you'd put on the, what do you call it, the drip irrigation system in a garden. Little hoses running out, little spray nozzles at the ends. Anyway, so we're going to be left with about 85% in this tank. Hopefully that's enough to get that done over there. Yeah, I've got a feeling that spraying is all I'm going to get done with this episode. That'll be fun. Well, you're having a little problem here, huh? You are because you think you've got to make this turn. Okay, that's understandable. If I'd started from here, probably would have had a problem with the trees over there too. But you did most of the work for me, and I am thankful for that. So bee and floor it. And we're good. Okay, X. Because he bounces around too much, so it doesn't seem reasonable to keep this thing fully extended to make this run. Let's do this and head over to this area. Now, how best to do this? I'd want to make one pass this direction at this end. I'd also want to... He's probably got plenty of room to handle the end up here, as far as the AI goes. So I don't think I need to put a buffer in here with this guy. Overspray with this guy isn't a problem. With a plow or a cultivator, it is. Or a sower. You know, tear up and sow soybeans into the grass area was a problem. But, get him unfolded. If I make one pass over here, I'm going to make the guess kind of right on the partition. That's not bad. I think we're going to call that one good. Little tiny more. Hire you out. Yeah, that works pretty good. Oh, I see. Folding it up takes it all the way up to the top. Interesting. So I'll have to manually set it for the crop height every time. It's not going to remember the old one. Okay. One pass in here. Then we'll set him up that direction and see what he does with the rest of the field. I One of these days, we may get to sell something here. I kind of have the memory of delivering something here once. I don't know if it was Unhire You in this playthrough or if it was one of my own personal games before I started the Let's Play series. Okay, let's see if I can find some kind of a middle point here. My backing up skills, which you only kind of call them that. Alright, that's not too bad right there. A little further. Like that? Yeah. Let's see what the AI can do with the existing sprayed area when he comes back. I think that's probably good right there. Back up this way to straighten him out and Hire You. Okay. But with the slope of the field and the slant, we tip from right to left and we go from top to bottom. The tractor is going to constantly be veering off to one side or another while I'm talking and trying to keep it straight. And I get to where I can't even finish a sentence when I'm constantly having to calculate at the same time. Math and English don't work well in my brain. Calculation, science, and language. Yep, this must be right side and left side or something. Anyway, what's he going to do at the end? This is a tiny little strip. On purpose, I wanted to maintain as much field as I could. But I think he can handle this. He can. Okay. It's enough to tell the computer that it ended. Yeah, I'm impressed with this. He's really thinking about it. She's really thinking about it. Baseball cap. Yeah, good alignment. Yeah, we'll look at it from this side for a while. Oh, it does look kind of funny with it up in the air like that. Tell you what, higher, drop down, mouse, and drop like so. Back up a touch, and higher. Yeah, that looks better. Of course, we're probably banging the tip over there. That for real ground response mod kind of exaggerates things. Well, I say that, but that is a lot of span out there. You hit a little bump with that tire, and that tire is a skinny little tire on the sprayer. Not a lot of surface area. So, yeah, I can see it being very possible to really bounce that guy around. Little movement at the tire is a lot of movement out here. So, I'm not going to say that's not real. Looking good there. I don't think we would have made it. Now, I'm pretty sure we would have hit that loading dock there if I hadn't put this one run. But this strategy right here, I'm liking. I might be doing that to a lot more of the fields to give a little more room for the AI to make his turns without having to go through and redo all the ends. You know, from stopping early because of an obstacle coming up. So that might be a way to, you know, still utilize the advantage of having the AI available, even in fields where the AI has kind of an aneurysm at the ends. And Klaus and I were talking about the problems I was having last episode with the combo that has the plow, the cultivator, and the sower, and I think what it comes down to is all the different trigger points that are involved. All the different calculations that the... What you doing? You didn't like that one, did you? Okay. Well, I'm going to take over then and do that one again. All the calculations between the plowing and the cultivating and the sowing. Remember, I want to say 10 episodes ago when Field 14, I had extended it a little bit, used the plow and made the field a little bit bigger. And I set the cultivator. Was it the cultivator? It was the sower. Well, one of the two. Let's see. Can't talk and calculate at the same time. B, run. And I'm curious, if I hire this out? Nope, didn't do any good. Okay. That didn't work. But, one of them turned around and just kept running right over the top of an area that was already done. I'm thinking it was the sowing. Nope, it was the cultivating. That's right. The cultivator just kept going. And I didn't expect that, so I didn't watch it. So I wasn't babysitting it. So the cultivator has no problem going over areas that he shouldn't have. The sower stopped right when it should have. You know, it did the two little rows and quit. So in that setup, you had the plow trying to decide if it needed to continue or whether what was in front of it was done. And then the cultivator trying to make those same decisions. And then the sower trying to make all those same decisions. So I think that has a lot to do with all the conflicts that were happening with the AI. I'm curious to see if we did that field over again with the same equipment, but without the edges all messed up from being a previously owned field. Part of it plowed, part of it cultivated, part of it sowed, and all those different triggers that it had to calculate if it would have... are you done? You're done. Thank you, Helper F. If it would have corrected itself and worked perfectly. So I think there was a lot going on in the background that we can't really appreciate. Just kind of watching it. So what are we going to do here? Let's find the center point here. Kind of like that. Yeah, something like that. Now B is this thumb button, right? Yeah. Let's do this. Turn that off. Alright, I'll try my turning around skills here. There we go, that's enough. Head over to here. So these big spans of sprayers, they sure get the job done quickly. Something like you, if I were to hire you out, what would you do? Well, you'd do a pretty good job. If you can do this one, it might even turn around up there. Yeah, the trees may kind of confuse it. I was thinking it might turn around and just hit that last little bit all by itself and do a good job, but we still have 63% fertilizer left. So this guy will do a big field. I don't know if it'll do field 5, but it will do an impressive size field. All right, unhire you and continue. There we go. All right, so best plan here is gradually turn him backwards. No, that's a little too gradual. There we go. Let's get up in here. About like so. That looks pretty good. Do this wedge, spin around, do the next wedge. So that's a lot of wasted fertilizer, huh? Okay, well, we've got this one now. We'll just do it like so. Or like that. Okay, job done. X folds him up. Let's go put him away. And I'm going to immediately start recording the next episode. We're going to go do some baling, mowing, windrowing, and baling, and just take a look at all that equipment. Let's get this guy back first. Where is he going to live? That's right, we do have a bay for spraying or fertilizing, and there's room for him in there. Well, I say that the middle was meant for being able to back in the smaller equipment and dive off to a side. Do we still have a side available? We do. Although that side is meant to get access to those. Well, it'll just have to work. Alright, so what do I need? Let's back him up. Okay. Zoom in here a little bit. Kind of like this. One bay, all the fertilizing implements. The next one, all the sowing. Although, when you mix sowing and cultivating and plowing, it's kind of hard to figure out exactly what goes where. See, that's far enough. That still gets us into that corner. So drop him off, and I'm going to call it done here. I'm going to dive into the next episode and start recording it. So this has been Noble Rambler. Thank you guys for watching, and I will catch you next time, folks. Bye-bye.